Today on BRS TV, we have our fourth episode of our Neptune Apex series with a short exploration of the energy bar. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRS TV, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week, we're going to give a brief overview of the energy bar and power management. The energy bar that comes with the standard Apex comes with 8 total outlets and has an overall power rating of 15 amps. So you should count the amps of all of your equipment and make sure it doesn't go over 15. In many cases, this won't be an issue, but on larger tanks with a lot of equipment, it can be. The biggest consumers of power are heaters, chillers, and halide or fluorescent lighting. There are also 2 different types of outlets on the energy bar. The 6 plugs on the left are all running TRIACs and can handle 5 amps. The 2 on the right are controlled via relays and can operate up to 10 amps each. There's also a handy chart over here which identifies which outlet is which and how many amps it can handle. You might wonder why they don't use relays on all of the outlets. It's because they make a small click when they turn on and off, and most people would prefer to avoid that on all the outlets. So keep this factor in mind when you decide what you're going to plug into that outlet. For instance, using this for a wave maker might not be the best use because it's constantly turning on and off. Some items that consume very small amounts of power, like dosing pumps or something similar, also operate best on the relay outlets. Either way, if the total amount of everything you plug in goes over 15 amps, you'll need to use multiple energy bars. People commonly ask, what if the 2 largest power consuming elements are unlikely to be on at the same time, like say a heater and a chiller? Can I go over 15 amps then? The advice is the same. It's super common to bump something on the interface and inadvertently turn on both, which would cause you to go over. Another thing to consider is your home's electrical supply. Most home circuits are also 15 amps, which means if you had a large system or one that consumes a ton of power, you can't get 2 energy bars, max them both out, and plug them both into the same outlet, because that'd be 30 amps. What you'll have to do is find an outlet on a different circuit or start cutting the largest power consuming items out of your system. You'll also need to consider what else in your home is on that circuit. If it's the same one you use your blow dryer, clothing iron, or mega entertainment system on, you're likely to run into some challenges. So what happens when you need more than 8 outlets? You have a few options. You can move some things that don't require control to a standard outlet, identify some low wattage items like power heads that can be consolidated into a power bar, and that power bar can be plugged into the Apex energy bar as long as the total of everything doesn't go over 15 amps. Lastly, you can pick up a second or third energy bar. They come in 4 and 8 blocks. For the most part, this is just a cost per outlet calculation. The Energy Bar 8 is $20 an outlet, and the Energy Bar 4 is $30 an outlet. If you absolutely know you'll never need more than 4 outlets, then the 4 is a good choice. If you're not sure, then the 8 is the right choice. The only other difference is the 4 has 4 outlets that are all running relays rather than TRIACs, which means they click and they can handle high or low energy consuming products better. Couple last tips. If you're having issues with an individual product not working correctly, try plugging it into one of the relay outlets on the end and it will likely solve your issue. Second, one of the best tools for measuring amps or watts is this cheap $20 tool called a kilowatt, which can tell you the power consumption information of every item on your system. If you have any questions or advice for your fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRS TV.